Dear colleagues, my name is Konstantin Vorontsov. I am professor in Moscow Institute of Physics and Technology and also in Yandex School of Data Analysis. I will speak about two research directions of my academic team. The first one is motivated by exploratory research, a relatively new paradigm in information retrieval. The second one is about medical diagnostics of internal diseases by electrocardiogram. Both research directions exploit the same technique and the same mathematics of probabilistic topic modeling. Let us begin with the first one. Thousands of students, professors, engineers, experts spend hours in Google, Bing, Yandex, Baidu every day to seeking new professional information, self-education, knowledge acquisition, and so on. However, present search engines realize only the lookup methodology of information retrieval, and they are inconvenient when the user is not familiar with the knowledge domain, or then the search goals are not clear to the user. In these situations, the user has to repeat his queries, browse the results, then refine his query again and again. The problem is that it is difficult to go far from the initial target for the initial query, starting point of the search. And it is almost impossible to obtain a complete picture of the problem domain. Often we hear the sad stories from our colleagues that they worked for a long time on the topic and after this then discovered the paper in which everything has been done before. It is it possible to make knowledge systematization automatically using recent achievements in information retrieval and machine learning? Let us imagine how the exploratory research should work from the user's point of view, from the point of view of us as scientists. This is a rough draft of the concept. The search query should be a document of any length or even a set of documents, a collection that a person collected for him or for his colleagues. The user would know what topics it contains, what else is known on these topics, what is the complex structure of corresponding knowledge domain? Which documents are more appropriate for experts? And which ones are recommended for the first reading? In our concept scenario, the user starts the exploratory search from a text query of any size, opened in a browser, a text editor, email editor, or any other text application. The color bar at the right side of the text window reflects the inner topical structure of the document. Different colors here denote different topics. User clicks a color bar to get textual and graphical representation of topics. This is one click entry point into exploratory search, as well as a reminder that knowledge is always at hand. First, the user learns what topics the text query contains and how they are nested into the global topical hierarchy. At that moment, the user can choose some of these subtopics in order to refine his query. Of course, our user can browse a search result page of topically similar documents. This view is quite familiar to any user of modern full-text search systems. But the most interesting is topic roadmap. This is a representation of a big picture, the complete clustering structure of the problem domain at hand. Continuing the geographical metaphor, we could assign the meanings to the land borders, cities, roads, rivers, poorly explored regions, etc. On this map, thus representing the land of knowledge to the user. Also, the user can navigate the global topical hierarchy. Using the topic river metaphor, our user can explore the dynamics of topics development in retrospect and learn more about neighbor topics and subtopics for any moment in the past. Finally, the user can investigate the detailed topical structure, internal structure of the query document, read an automatically extracted summary of the query document. So many text visualization techniques potentially useful for exploratory search are now available as ready-to-use technologies for text analysis and particularly for topic modeling of large collections. Almost all technologies are ready now to assemble the exploratory search engine. This is web crawling, content filtering, inverted indexing, ranking, and visualization. In particular, we can use any existing inverted indexing engine with only difference that we search documents by their topics instead to search documents by their words. The keystone technology for the exploratory search is topic modeling. The problem is that topic models for exploratory search must meet too many requirements at once. Topics should be well interpretable by human and labeled automatically. Terminological key phrases should be extracted automatically also. The search engines should support the cross-language and multi-language search. The model should recover the topic dynamics over time, the topic hierarchy, and the topical segmentation structure of any document. All of these above extensions of topic models are known in the vast literature, but the challenge is to combine them into one multi-objective topic model and also to meet the requirements of big data, such as online, parallel, distributed processing. How to implement this dream? Let us start from definitions. Intuitively, topic is a set of coherent terms from a particular domain area. More formally, topic is a probability distribution over terms. For example, we distinguish mathematical and biological texts by frequencies of terminological words. On the other hand, we would represent each document by a probability distribution over topics. This distribution is a very compressed representation of the document semantics that we are going to use for building inverted index in exploratory search engine. Probabilistic topic modeling is based on a two-stage degenerative model of text. At the first stage, the model generates a topic for each term position in each document. At the second stage, the model generates a term from a conditional distribution over terms chosen at the first stage. But our goal to solve the inverse problem. Given an observed document collection, that is, counters how many times each term appear in each document, we would find the unknown parameters of the generative model, phi, the matrix of conditional distributions over terms for each topic, and theta, conditional distributions over topics for each document. This is an ill-posed problem of non-negative matrix factorization, which is it is ill-posed because it have infinitely many solutions, and then additional regularizations are to be used to obtain the unique and stable solution. Probabilistic latent semantic analysis proposed by Thomas Hoffman historically was the first approach to the problem. It is based on likelihood maximization without regularization. Karush-Kontakier conditions give a system of equations that can be solved by sample iteration method. So it is very natural to use this method here because left sides of each equation are model parameters, and right side of each equation is some function of these parameters. And also, auxiliary variable PTDV is very well probabilistically interpreted because this is posterior probability of topic for each word in each document. The next significant advance in topic modeling was the latent Dirichlet allocation proposed by David Blay, Andrew Inn, and Michael Jordan. Up to now, the paper is the most citable in topic modeling research field. They proposed to use Dirichlet prior distribution for regularization. And also, they proposed variational Bayesian inference, thus predetermining the development path of topic modeling for the next decade. Classical non-Bayesian regularization is an alternative way, going back to the work of Soviet mathematician Andrei Tikhonov. We maximize the log likelihood with an arbitrary additive regularization criterion. Karush-Kontakier conditions in this case also result in a system of equations that can be solved with EM-like algorithm, but for any regularization criteria, and these formula are very simple for any regularization criteria, and they like to gradient descent methods. We call this approach RTM, additive regularization for topic modeling. Bayesian inference is more sophisticated and does not lead to sample formula generalizable for any prior distribution. Any Bayesian model can be interpreted via additive regularization. In some cases, abandoning redundant probabilistic assumptions leads to useful generalization. For example, we would like to have a well-interpretable model with lots of sparse and decorrelated topics containing domain-specific terminology of the problem domain, and a few dense topics containing stop words and common lexis words. To smooth the background topics, we minimize the Kullback-Leibler divergence between the model distribution phi and the fixed distribution beta, and also between model parameters theta and the fixed vector alpha. But this is strictly equivalent to the LDA. This is the same formula of M step that LDA has. To sparse the domain specific topics, we contrary maximize the same KL divergences. The result is turning signs from plus to minus here and here. Despite the simplicity, we don't know what Bayesian prior would give such result. So minus is prohibited for the Dirichlet distribution. This is a very simple generalization possible only in our semi-probabilistic approach. Another useful regularizer is sparsing Useful regularizer is decorrelating of domain-specific topics. The inference is very trivial, and it is one-line differentiation of the regularization criterion. Another useful regularizer is sparsing of whole distribution over topics. It produces a very interesting effect of topic selection, because the less significant rows of the theta matrix vanish and turn to zero, because we have here the rows here, the negative elements. But the main feature of addition regularization of topic models is a possibility to combine topics, topic models. The original ill-posed problem has a so huge stock of solutions that we can add maximization criteria to the log likelihood more and more. For example, after making our topics highly decorrelated, we can proceed with another regularization criterion and make them, besides, highly sparse. But that this is not all. The next stage of generalization is to learn multimodal probabilistic topic models. In real collections, documents usually have metadata, including authors, affiliations, time, images and objects on images, citation and links on other documents, advertising banners attached to the web pages, users that read, download, comment, like, dislike documents, and so on. All these kinds of additional data can be processed uniformly. A multimodal topic model describes each document as a container of tokens of multiple modalities. For example, the user ID can be considered a special word attributed to the document. Generally, we have a set of modalities, M, a vocabulary of tokens for each modality, WM, and we maximize a weighted sum of the log likelihoods, one log likelihood per each modality. So each modality can be considered as a regularizer too. Or we can consider this problem as multi-criteria optimization via scalarization of multiple criteria. But the YAML-like algorithm remains substantially the same. So the only difference is that here appears coefficients of regularization, and here normalization can be done for each modality separately. Multimodality covers a great number of recent topic models proposed in separately. Author topic model, tag topic model, entity topic model, citation topic model, etc., etc., that we read in the literature. In multimodal, we generalized all these as special cases. In multi-language models of parallel collections, also each language can play a role of modality. In hierarchical models, the topics of the parent level can form a modality. In multigram topic models, unigram, bigram, figram, and so on can be also modalities. So this is very general approach, but very simple. Another extension of RTM removes the bag of words assumption. To do this, we introduce the sum of regularizers depending on position of terms. I is the position of term W in the document D. This time, the YAM algorithm remains again, except for the inclusion of a special post-processor stage after usual E step. The details of this approach are presented in the poster of Anna Potapenko, and I also can answer questions about this work. Now then, non-Bayesian additively regularized topic models are easy to understand, easy to combine, and easy to implement. Additive regularization allows you to bind a variety of models in a new manner by simple selecting a subset of predefined regularizers from a supplied library. You simply check boxes in the list of items, and that's all. Our implementation of this idea is freely available as an open source cross-platform project, BigRTM, for parallel, online, multimodal, regularized topic modeling of large text collections. We provide a very permissive license so for both commercial and academic usage, and invite everyone to join this project. The parallel architecture is based on the standard idea to break the collection into batches and to process them separately. For a large collection, BigRTM works out of core. That is, the collection is never loaded into the memory as a whole. We exploit an important structural feature of topic models. Each column of thematics depends on the corresponding document, whereas a thematic depends on the whole collection. So we periodically synchronize all updates of the thematic computed by processors. For a large collection, thematic usually converges after a small part of the collection. So one pass through the collection is sufficient. And as a result, the algorithm works like a linear time algorithm that performs big clustering of documents and terms into topics. Next, I will make a quick overview of our experiments with BigRTM. First, we show that BigRTM is linearly scalable. In the second experiment, BigRTM outperforms its counterparts, the concurrent topic modeling tools from the popular freely available projects, GenSim and Wobble-Wabbit. All of them implement the same online EM algorithm with many technical differences, but we see that our implementation is a bit more accurate. In the third experiment, we show that a combination of regularizers improves sparsity without a loss of the log likelihood or perplexity of the model. The red curves are for regularized model here, the sparsity of regularized model, and blue ones are for PLSA model without regularization. So they have the same perplexity, but sparsing properties are very different. In the next experiment, we build the hierarchical topic model of two Russian conferences on machine learning, mathematical methods of pattern recognition and intellectualization of information processing. Here we use the combination of seven regularizers to make topics sparse, decorrelated, free of stop words, and the most important, to bind subtopics with their parent topics. In the next experiment, we used two different modalities for unigram and bigram. The interpretability of bigrams is dramatically better. Being the program committee member of these conferences, And looking at the bigrams, I can easily interpret each topic as a research field or concrete scientific school, and in some cases, and can guess the authors. The unigram model is not so well interpretable, so this the guessing thereafter is not possible for unigram model. The last experiment is for temporal topic model. We use two additional regularizers. The first one for sparsing time distribution over topics. For sparsing, we use Kullback-Leibler optimization, Kullback-Leibler divergence. The second regularizer for this task is smoothing topic distribution over time. So here we use the distribution of topic conditional for time moment y, and here, contrary, we fixed a topic t, and we smooth the time series of probabilities for that topic. We built a topic model for political press releases in English, covering a 10-year period. The purpose was to find event topics, persistent topics, and to mine topic correlations. Here there are examples of persistent topics about healthcare and education. This is an example of two event topics, about Russia and about Syria, that the model determined as highly correlated at some moment, 4 years ago, not now. this is an example, this is a brief summary. This is a brief summary for topic modeling. Exploratory research motivates combining topic models to meet dozens of criteria at once. The state-of-the-art Bayesian approach are too sophisticated for this purpose. We propose a simple and powerful approach we call RTM, based on additive regularization. We implemented this idea in the open source project BigRTM, and we invite everyone to join the project. The second part of my talk is about topic modeling for medical diagnostics. Electrocardiography has a long history, more than a century of research and development. And all this time, ECG, electrocardiography, has been used for diagnosis of cardiovascular disorders. Many researchers have attempted to confirm or referred hypothesis that ECG signal carries information about many internal diseases, not only cardiac disorders. Recently, Professor Vyacheslav Uspensky succeeded to find specific patterns of signal variability that various diseases produce in ECG record. To validate his theory of information function of the heart, so this is medical theory, Uspensky collected a training set of 20,000 ECG records with clinically verified diagnosis, over 40 of the most common internal diseases. Each record consists of 600 cardiocycles, which corresponds to from 6 to 8 minutes of observation. This experimental work continued for more than 15 years and is still ongoing. Our machine learning group joined this research work 2 years ago. The idea is very similar to the heart rate variability analysis. In the HRV analysis, only the variability of intervals between peaks is used. Uspensky proposed to extract more information from the ECG data and to analyze together the increments of amplitudes of intervals and also their ratio alpha between them. A sample visualization shows that the variations of these increments are not random, and that each disease exhibit some specific patterns of variability. But we don't understand these patterns when we see these charts. We need machine learning to find these patterns automatically. We use not the increments themselves, but only the signs of the increments, because their values depend on the device and the conditions of the signal registration. We encode possible combinations of the signs of the increments into symbols A, B, C, D, F. Thus, the ECG record is encoded into a symbolic sequence, each symbol representing one cardiac cycle. Then we transform the encoded cardiogram into a feature vector representation convenient for machine learning algorithm. As features, we use frequencies of triplets of consecutive symbols. We experimented much with different versions of the discretization and found that the six-symbol encoding and the fragment size of three symbols are optimal. To learn the classifier, we use a supervised topic model with two modalities. So supervised can be realized by multimodal, two modalities, multimodal topic model. Class labels and first modality is our triplets or words containing three symbols each, and second modality is a class that is the disease. Probabilistic topic model returns the probability of each disease for each ECG record, which is very useful for risk assessment. And we use additive regularizers for sparsing, decorrelation, model two modalities, and to find compact clusters of frequent triplets for each disease. Cross-validation experiments show surprisingly high levels of specificity and sensitivity. This is almost impossible, you may think, but this is the fact. We compute the AOC, area under specificity sensitivity curve. Now we are working on cloud servers for remote multi-disease diagnostics. Our research group has begun collaboration with CardioQuark, a Russian startup company, which launches a smart case for iPhone with ECG recorder. Recently, we did a first toy experiment on data provided by CardioQuark. They don't have yet reliable data on medical diagnosis, but instead they have a field, smoke or not smoke, that users fill at registration. We learned this target and obtained the cross-validated AOC higher than 90%. Conclusions. The high accuracy diagnostics of many internal diseases from a single ECG is not fairy tale and not a pseudoscience. We confirmed that in many experiments. Other biomedical signals may also carry valuable information about human state, disorders, and diseases. We are entering in a very interesting era of portable devices, remote, decentralized medical diagnostics, and preventative healthcare. And we hope that big data, machine learning, symbolic dynamics, and computational linguistics techniques will be useful to decipher the language of the human body. Thank you very much.